Hello viewers, welcome to another episode of our show today on Journey Towards Entrepreneurship, and I'm your host Timi Tokwe Adigwe. I have a guest in the studio this morning. He is a business tycoon, he's a serial entrepreneur and also a business coach. He's the chairman of Benvic Mart Limited. He is into solar energy and all, and he has all the multiple businesses alongside. His name is Mr. Ebenezer Ajayi. Hello, Mr. Ebenezer Ajayi.
Yeah, hello. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for joining us. You're welcome to Tribune Online TV.
Yeah,
yes, Tribune Online TV, I forgot to mention it. Yes, over to our question for today. Can you tell us about you, please?
Okay, like you've said, my name is Ebenezer Ajayi. Okay. I'm the chairman of Benvic Mart Limited. Okay. Having it as a group.
Okay.
So having it as a living group. Yeah, okay, so basically we are into two major businesses.
Okay.
To be well streamlined, we're into Benvic Solar and Investment Management.
Oh.
So those are the two businesses we have. But prominent out of the two is the Benvic Solar, the popular Benvic Solar that people know and people are familiar with.
All right. So at Benvic Solar, what exactly do you do?
All right. At Benvic Solar, we do all that it is to solar and inverter system. We couple, we manufacture inverters from start to finish.
Wow.
All right. From the casing, the stocks inside it.
Okay.
Then we do installations as well. We do trainings to people who want to train. Then we do instrumental payment system. We offer instrumental payment system to people. Quite a lot of things. Then we also take in investment from people who want to invest in the business.
Oh, so if I get you correctly, it means you manufacture your solar power yourself, and also you provide an opportunity to invest into it. So it means if I want to get solar, and for example, I don't have up to the amount I need to get one, I can start investing and still have my solar.
Very well. People drop for instance, one of our packages that go for 150,000 naira, for example, we have someone that invested 50,000 naira a couple of months ago, and before you know it has grown to a level where you can have your inverter system. That's a part.
Wow. All
right. And then the other part is you come in on the platform of our instrumental payment system.
Okay.
You pay, make a down payment, and we come to install in your house.
Oh.
So probably you are a salary earner, or a business person that we can confirm that is part of our list.
Okay.
Right, so you get to spread the payment for 6 months and 1 year, as the case may be.
Okay.
All right. So those are the packages that we have, brought on board to make us unique and get, the cliche, people believe solar system is quite expensive. So we have actually created that to make it a bit lower for and affordable for people.
So in short, it's not just for the wealthy people.
No.
Average people can afford solar and get a good and satisfying solar for their homes.
Yeah.
Wow, that's, I must commend that. That's a beautiful idea. So now talking about solar and looking at your profile, you are actually a linguist. And with interaction with you, I noticed that you even have background in communications and media. You've done quite a lot of things. So tell me, from linguistics to entrepreneurship, how did that happen?
Okay, I'm a language person. I studied linguistics. But then I realized I have the ability to make things work. Make 1 + 1 to become, 2, or probably more than that as it may be. Alright, so I was in the media for 2 years.
Wow.
In the electronic media for 2 years, and I did my path then. But during my service year, I discovered more about me. Then I started making chalk, started producing chalk on my own.
Wow.
So I was training hall members, I was training, even local government inspectors were coming to train under me. So quite a lot of things were coming in place. So before I actually carved out my niche with solar systems.
Actually, you sound like a very interesting man to me, from media to NYSC to producing chalk and now to solar. You're just you're bringing everything, connecting everything together. So I must ask, how did the inspiration for chalk come up? And who were the people you were distributing chalk to? Because actually, secondary schools and primary schools are the ones that use chalk. Where were you manufacturing it? What state, or is there people, who were you producing for? And did you make profit as it's
When I finished my first degree some years back now, the first thing I went to was to teach English language. As a linguist, I've been studying English. What to do is to teach English language in schools.
Yeah.
It's quite disheartening that that's the hope of many of us that study things that are related to, like, you don't get a job.
Mm.
But then, so, by where I was actually teaching English language, I was the English teacher, the only English teacher that actually taught from GSS 1 to SS 3.
Wow.
You know, so then, while I was teaching, the Spirit of God permits me to make that.
You're permitted.
So the Spirit of God actually sounded that into my ears. That chalk, stop producing this chalk you're using.
Mm.
You know, I went home, I used my Google, so the power of Google.
Yeah.
How to make chalk at home.
Wow.
You understand? So that was why I got the lowdown how to produce chalk.
Mm.
You know, it's something so funny to today. I still recall how I started producing chalk. My dad's car park was my official, the first office I had.
Wow.
And he had to bring his car house. I started manufacturing my chalk there. Everything, I learned everything online, no single tutor.
So I must say this, send this home. For graduates who are still, you know, trying to get a job and all, you don't have to wait for that federal government job. Think of something you can do within your niche, within your family, and get it done. Really, it pays. So over to you, sir.
All right.
You're talking about your daddy's car park.
Yeah.
You mentioned something like park. I want to ask, were you born with a silver spoon or with a wooden spoon? Because really, you know, some entrepreneur people will say that, I was not born with a silver spoon, so I don't know, I need capital to start. I need so amount of money to start. What do you have to say about that? Your dad had a car park. It means he was probably a big boy, you know.
Well, I don't think I was born with any of those spoons.
Okay.
Because, he had his car while I was graduating. Yes,
from secondary school or?
No, from the university. So
his first car?
Not his first car really, but his most obvious car. Then so that was what I can't say he's a retired teacher, so he's an average man. Then so there was nothing special about it. I saved my salary. I didn't mention how much I was earning. My remuneration while I was teaching, I was earning 13,000 naira.
Wow.
You know, you understand what it is to teach English language from GSS 1 to GSS 3, earning 13,000 naira. That was my saving. So from there I could.
Well, even NYSC Alawi was more than that.
So I actually brought something out of my savings then to get the chop mode. And a sister of mine who actually believed in me, actually supported me. Not something quite much though. And I got the contact of the person who sells the mode till now.
Okay.
On Google, everything on Google, everything online. So there was no special information. With my small tiny phone, I got the information online.
That's another warning.
Yeah.
Don't use your phone for social media alone. You get details and information on social media.
Yeah, so that was how everything played out. I got everything I needed to get, and I started producing. Now, in Afro-Ekiti State, I need to say that where I grew up in Ekiti State, there are about 22 towns and villages. Alright, and I actually grew up there. I wasn't brought up in Lagos. Alright, so I'm always proud to say that anyway. And I discovered that there is no single chalk producer in the whole 22,000 villages.
Wow.
Alright, so one God inspires you, it's always very, very unique. And I became the first chalk producer, that was in 2013, in the whole 22,000 villages.
Wow.
So the whole proprietors, they were at my mercy.
Wow.
They come to line up at the front of my dad to pick chalk.
Wow.
So even the school I was teaching then, they have to beg me on that to get chalk for them.
Wow.
Alright, so that was how everything started. And then once I started training core members and all that, then it got to the time I no longer produce chalk. I was only supplying the mold for those I have trained. That was how everything graduated to becoming into the solar, to the investment management and several other ones that I was in the
program. Yeah, that's a process to growth.
Yeah.
To grow you have to start from somewhere. It started from chalk. So supplying molds and now on the solar. Now back to solar. What was the inspiration behind solar? Why solar?
Okay, several inspirations from solar.
Yeah.
I'll still trace the first inspiration to my dad as well.
Okay.
You know, when he retired, that was in 2017, basically, we thought, what can we do for this man? Then he was 70 years, he wanted to do his 78th birthday. So my siblings, they came together that, okay, let's present something to this man. So they knew then that I was the technically savvy person, I was the business-oriented person in the house. So they told me, what we do? I said, okay, no problem, let's do something. Because in that place that I talked about, where I grew up, in that particular place, there has been blackout for the past 5 years. Now it's about 6 years.
Wow.
No single lights there.
Wow.
And here is a retired person that loves news and all that very much. So you have to say, okay, let's get a solar system for this person. So you have to call on me, hey guy, supervise this project. And that became my first official project.
Mm.
So any assignment given to you, you do it properly well. That would be your next line of work.
Mm. That's
true. So I just called people that do this. So that engineer come, you come. And I went to Alaba International Market myself to buy all the materials. I read everything online. Because I'm conversant with online. Why would I just chat people up without bringing money for myself? So that was how everything started. So we did the project, my dad was happy. See, today the solar system is still working perfectly because I got the best of materials for him.
Mm.
And so since then I did it. If I could do this, why? Then I was working with the telecom, let me mention in particular. I was working with the telecom then, so I just felt, hey, I think I should do more in this area. So I snapped the picture of my dad's project. I started training on social media. Let me do yours. So contracts started rolling in Abuja, in Lagos, and several places.
Wow.
It is what it is now. Yeah.
So if you don't mind, can you tell us the length of your client base? Like how far in the country, have you supplied outside the country or still in the country? Mm. And in the country, like how many states have you covered?
Okay, the whole Southwest.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Then Abuja, I'm quite sure of that, Abuja. And then in Abuja twice, two or three times in Abuja.
Okay.
Then in Loring, all those areas. Mm. It's only north, so I've not been to the north. I've not been to the north, but my boys have been to the north.
Oh,
yeah, myself, I've not been to the north, but my boys have gone to the north to do some installations.
So talking about your boys means you have people working with you?
Engineers. Yes.
Wow, a linguist employed an engineer. Did you employ them?
It's quite an irony. The way it works is there are some that are permanent staff with us. You know, but most of them, my style is I don't really hire people to stay with me and stay with me.
Mm.
You stay with me, you get blessed, you get established. So I tell them, you work with me permanently for 6 months and you are not starting something on your own. You're fired.
Well, so more, you're more like an inspiration to young people.
So if we get you in, we train you, we empower you, you start getting something, so we become partners. That way my territory is becoming larger. So that has been my style so far. Some said, you know, I said, okay, that's my style and that's been blessing me.
And relationship is the key to life, actually.
Very well. Very well.
Yes, talking about your businesses, the solar and the investment, so you're a family man. So I'm sorry if I'm going to enter that way, but I just want to ask, how are you able to combine your businesses and the family? I mean, you're a family man, you are a businessman, also your social life. How are you able to combine everything? Or how are you, because you're still combining them together?
No, it's easy to combine. It's not something, I don't even see it as combination, so to speak. It's a normal way of life.
Mm.
You understand? It's, the kind of upbringing you have determines how easy some things are for you. All right. My family, they are part of the business already. As I'm talking to you now, my wife, they are also working somewhere business-wise as well, doing something in one of our departments because we run financial inclusion as well.
Okay.
All right. So we have POS centers across the board. So she's managing somewhere as well. So she knows I'm here as I'm talking to you. So everything works hand in hand. So I don't see anything special. Then social life, I'm not that social anyway. The only social life I have is the church, I dance and
Alright, that's more like it. That's also social life.
Yeah.
So now talking about funds.
Okay.
One thing we notice business people actually, you know, complain about is raising funds for their businesses and really raising capital. And really, to some extent, I agree. But your background to coming into the business line, you've never mentioned anything like, you know, okay, you said you saved up. Can you talk about the place of fund and starting up, especially for startups, people that are, you know, trying to look into coming into the solar energy, not just solar energy, in any kind of business? Do they have to wait for a particular amount?
Okay, all right. There is a basic understanding that God made me to understand.
Okay.
And that's the fact that every human is selfish. The person you think has money that is not ready to help you is so selfish, waiting for you to offer something and invest. All right, so you have not really made your content available to people. When you make your content available to people, people would want to invest, not because they like you, but because we want to profit from it.
Mm.
All right, so that's just the, let me just use that as a summary of what actually happened in my own case.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so people saw what I brought on the table, and they felt, okay, we can partner, a particular brand, let me mention the bank, called me on social media, they saw my profile and everything, and they just called me, hey, let's give you some money to do instrumental payment, I mean, system for 1,000 homes in 2020.
Wow.
You need to already. So the people, everybody, they are not doing it because they like Ebenezer. They are doing it because they want to make profit out of the platform I've created. So create a platform. People will come. It's a matter of time.
So just to wrap it up, what's your word? That word, single word for your upcoming entrepreneurs.
Okay. So entrepreneurs that are there, start now. Now is the time to plant a tree. You know, because when you start something now, it starts growing immediately, no matter how weak it looks. You know, I started in Badong itself with 5,000 naira. All right, somebody gave me an office to start with, seeing what I do. So many people want to come to your aid, but don't bother about what is happening right now. Just start in your little sphere of influence.
Right. Thank you very much, Mr. Ebenezer, for coming to this show. We really appreciate you. So viewers at home, there is something about value, adding value to whatever you're doing as an entrepreneur, whatever thing you're doing, be sure to add value. There cannot be profit without additional or important or sufficient value. When people see what you're doing, they will be ready to pay for it. That's the word for today. Join us same time or the day. Enjoy the rest of the day and stay blessed.